A new CIRES research study finds people of color are exposed to higher levels of air pollution than non-Hispanic whites in the city of Denver. We used satellite data and computer modeling to map differences in air quality among Denver's neighborhoods. We compared the maps to demographic data to see if air pollution disproportionately affects some communities over others. Our results show that people who identify as Hispanic, Latino, or American Indian tend to live in the neighborhoods that are closest to the sources of Denver's pollution, such as highways and Colorado's only oil refinery. As a result, they breathe the worst air in the city. We found that our results can partly be explained by Denver's history, with one example being racist mortgage lending practices from the mid-20th century. In the 1880s, the northeast part of the city became a hub for refining gold and silver ore. Immigrants and people of color flocked to these neighborhoods to work at the smelteries and newly constructed railroads that brought ore to the city from the mines in the Rocky Mountains. Then, in 1935, the federal government had a private company create residential security maps of Denver and 200 other U.S. cities. The maps ranked every neighborhood in a given city from A to D, with A being the most desirable and D being the least. The lower the grade a neighborhood received, the less likely its residents were to get their mortgage insured. This practice, known as redlining, made it difficult or impossible for residents of certain neighborhoods to access mortgage financing. The smeltery and railroad workers' neighborhoods of Denver were given D grades, in some cases specifically because they were populated by people of color. Our study found that some aspects of Denver's history, including the practice of redlining, contribute to the disparities in air quality we see today. Redlining was outlawed in 1968, but many other racist zoning practices, like racial covenants, continued to be illegally enforced. We found people of color make up the majority of residents in the historically redlined districts of Denver, and the former D neighborhoods are still plagued by poor air quality. Denver's two major highways pass through the former smeltery workers' neighborhoods, and oil and gas production is ongoing at nearby Commerce City. We found that former D neighborhoods have 13% higher levels of nitrogen dioxide, a pollutant from vehicle emissions, than former A neighborhoods do. Our work shows that Denver is but one example of how communities of color experience worse air quality in major cities around the country. We hope our work will provide a tool for addressing these inequalities.